In gym class, you're going to be playing a team game. Your class has been put into 6 groups with 4 students in each group. The groups have then been instructed to stand in lines. Huh. Your class has just organized themselves into an array. An array is a way to show multiplication as rows and columns. To construct an array, there needs to be a row for each group. Since your class has 6 groups, this array has 6 rows. The row has 4 columns. There's a column for each object in the group. Your class has 4 students in each group, so there are 4 columns. You can use the array to find how many students are in your class by skip counting each row. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, dot, dot, dot. There are 24 students in your class. Hopefully your team wins. Now that you've seen how to create an array from a multiplication problem, try turning this multiplication into an array to solve it. Okay, you have 3 groups of stars. To create an array, you would need 3 rows. Awesome. You know that each group has 5 stars. That means you need 5 columns. Great work. Fill in the rest of the rows to have 3 groups of 5. By skip counting the rows, you can find out how many total stars there are. 5, 10, 15. There are 15 stars. You're on a roll. Keep going. Mary is baking cookies. She has 3 groups of 4 cookies on the pan. Can you create an array to find the total number of cookies Mary is baking? Okay, you have 3 groups, which means your array will have 3 rows. Keep going. Each group has 4, so you create 4 columns. Finish filling out your array, and now you can find the answer. 4, 8, 12. Mary baked 12 cookies. You've been creating arrays to represent multiplication problems. Now try creating a multiplication problem from an array. Look at this array. Start by counting how many rows there are. This is how many groups there are. There are 2 groups here. Now you can count the number of columns. This is how many objects are in each group. There are 5 columns. So, this array has 2 groups of 5. 2 multiplied by 5 equals 10. All right, now you try. Problem 3. You and a friend are playing cards. Your friend sets the cards up in the following array. Write and solve a multiplication sentence that represents the array. Looking at the array that is shown, you'll need to create a multiplication sentence and solve it to find the total number of cards. You can start by counting the number of rows and columns. There are 5 rows, so that means you have 5 groups. You can count the columns to find 10. Each of the groups has 10 cards, so you have 5 groups of 10 cards. Now change it to a multiplication sentence. 5 multiplied by 10. Perfect! 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. There are 50 cards. Great job. Keep practicing with this problem. Farmer Nick planted 5 rows of beans. Each row had 7 beans. Create an array and find the total number of beans that Farmer Nick planted. Okay, start by creating the array. You have 5 rows. Each row has 7 beans. So add the columns to make sure there are 7 columns. Great. Now, create the multiplication problem. 5 rows and 7 columns means 5 multiplied by 7. Now you solve. 7 plus 7 is 14. 14 plus 7 is 21. 21 plus 7 is 28. Last row, 28 plus 7 is 35. There are 35 bean plants in total. Let's do just one more. All right. In order to create and solve a multiplication problem with this array, we need to first find out how many rows and columns there are. First, we can count the rows. There are 4 rows. Now we count the columns. There are 2 columns, and this means we have 4 groups of 2. We can now create and solve a multiplication problem. 4 multiplied by 2. So, the answer is 8. Great job! Fantastic! You did some great work today. Now let's review what you learned. Multiplication can be shown by using an array, which uses rows and columns. The number of groups is equal to the number of rows, And how many objects you have in each group gives you the number of columns. Arrays will help you to visualize multiplication. And then you'll be a master multiplier in no time. See you soon.